from the patient one. When they both submitted to Allah, the father and the son, وَقَلَّهُ لِلْجَبِيلِ He laid him down in Mina, where our camp is, in order to spare him. And he sharpened his knife, and he turned his face away from him. Ismail said, Father, turn my face away from you, so that we don't have an eye contact, so that we do not think about it for a moment, so that we do not disobey the command of Allah. He sharpens his knife and he tries to sacrifice his son, but the knife won't go through. He sharpens his knife again, but the knife won't go through. And again, وَنَادَيْنَاهُ Then Allah the Almighty said, We called upon him, Ya Ibrahim, فَنَصَدَّقْتَ الرُّؤْيَا You have verified the night vision. You have fulfilled the command. وَفَدَيْنَاهُ بِذِبْحٍ عَظِيمٍ And we asked him, We ask of Ismail alayhi salam with a great sacrifice, this prayer which Allah the Almighty sent down from heaven to be sacrificed in the stead of Ismail alayhi salam. One of our camp in Mina is where we spent the last night is known as Madar al-Kafsh. There is a huge mountain behind us. This is the mountain from which, one upon which the Ram descended from heaven. Then Ibrahim alayhi salam sacrificed this Ram in his state. And that's why the entire Ummah until the Day of Judgment will continue on every Eid al-Adha to sacrifice this head to commemorate the remembrance of this blessed family of Ibrahim alayhi salam. وَإِذْ ابْتَلَى إِبْرَاهِيمَ رَبُّهُ بِكَلِمَاتٍ فَأَتَمَّهُنَّ When he passed all the tests, himself, his wife, and his son, Allah the Almighty blessed the poor, with the greatest honor, with the task of building the Kaaba. وَإِذْ يَرْفَعُ إِبْرَاهِيمُ الْقَوَاعِدَ مِنَ الْبَيْتِ وَإِسْمَعِيلِ Remember, when Ibrahim and his son Ismail now were commanded to build the house, and they were raising the foundations of the ancient house, البيت الحرام الكعبة What happened? This is a very special command in a special place to very specific people from Allah directly. What an honor! Upon completing building the Kaaba, what dua would you do? When you know that Allah the Almighty have chosen you, only you, out of all the believers, to recompense His house. Their dua was, رَبَّنَا تَقَبَّلْ مِنَّا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ Our Lord, accept from us, because as Qabool is not for granted. We do our best, we do the good deeds, and we ask Allah the Almighty to accept. Could it be not accepted? Yes, of course, it is entirely up to Allah the Almighty. The very first dua that Ibrahim and Ismail alayhi salam made after building the Kaaba, رَبَّنَا تَقَبَّلْ مِنَّا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ Our Lord, accept this effort from us. Indeed, you are the all-hearer, the all-knowing. Then the second dua, رَبَّنَا وَجْعَلْنَا مُسْلِمَنِّ لَكَ وَمِنْ ذُرِّيَّتِنَا أُمَّةً مُسْلِمَةً Our Lord, make us both Muslimain and make some of our offspring Muslims. Because it's understood that not all the offspring of Ibrahim a.s. would be believers. Alhamdulillah, 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 Allah chose us brothers and sisters to be among this system. Min ummati, ummatan muslimatana. Min durriyati, ummatan muslimatana. So this is the greatest blessing. Alhamdulillah, alladhi hadana li ni'mat al-Islam. وَكَفَى بِهَا نِعْمَةٌ Indeed, it is the greatest blessing to be rightly guided. Subhanallah, out of billions of human beings, only few whom Allah Almighty chose to be rightly guided. And indeed, that is the greatest blessing ever. Brothers and sisters, it is the power of dua. When Ibrahim alayhi salam made dua, even though he was denied, Allah granted him the son. When Zakaria alayhi salam made dua, كلما دخل عليها زكريا المحراب وجد عندها رزقا قال يا مريم أنى لك هذا قالت هو من عند الله إن الله يرزق من يشاء بغير حساب هنالك دعا زكريا ربه زكريا invoked الله when he reached serenity رب هب لي من لدنك ذرية طيبة إنك سميع الدعاء what did he do? Did he say, Oh Allah, give me a son to be adopted? to be a professor, to be a lawyer, to be a dentist. This is all secondary. What matters most, what achieves success, is to be righteous. رَبِّ هَبْنِي مِنْ لَدُنْكَ ذُرِّيَّةً طَيِّبَةً. My Lord, grant me from yourself a goodly offspring. Allah is teaching us how to make dua. You don't say, just give me dhurriyyah, just give me offspring, or make my children successful in the dunya. What matters most to be successful in akhirah. هَبْنِي مِنْ لَدُنْكَ ذُرِّيَّةً طَيِّبَةً إِنَّكَ سَمِيعُ الدُعَاءِ. فنادته الملائكة وهو قائم يصلي في المحراب أن الله يبشرك بيحيى. So the angels called upon him while he was standing in the prayer in the mihrab that Allah is giving you the bishara that he will grant you a son. Even though he has been invoking Allah for a son, but he couldn't imagine after all and after station serenity, and his wife was already sterile. قال أنا يكون لي غلام وقد بلغني الكبر وامرأتي عاقر. This is a human mentality. How come? How could this ever happen? It's none of your business. That is Allah's business. There is no impossible for Allah. إنما أمره إذا أراد شيئا أن يقول له كن فيكون. His command to anything, whenever he wants anything to happen, he just says to it, be, and it is. It is your day today, brothers and sisters. It is the day of the dua. In the hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, خَيْرُ الدُّعَاء دُعَاءُ يَوْمِ عَرَفَةً. The best dua ever is the dua which is made on the day of Arafah. That is the best dua. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam guided us as how to make dua. He said, وَخَيْرُ مَا قُلْتُ أَنَا وَالنَّبِيُّونَ مِنْ قَبْلِي. The best supplication I invoke Allah with myself and all the prophets before me is to say, لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ وَحْدَهُ لَا شَرِيكَ لَهُ لَهُ الْمُلْكُ وَلَهُ الْحَمْدُ يُحْيِي وَيُمِيتُ وَهُوَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ. Even if you do not get a chance to ask Allah for anything and you keep up buying your time, why the thing? It is sufficient. All your needs will be fulfilled. Yet Allah the Almighty is also teaching us in the Quran, فَإِذَا قَضَيْتُمْ مَنَاسِكَكُمْ فَاذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ كَذِكْرِكُمْ آبَاءَكُمْ أَوْ أَشَدَّ ذِكْرًا. فَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَقُولُ رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا وَمَا لَهُ فِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنْ خَلَاقٍ. وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ يَقُولُ رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنَةً وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ حَسَنَةً وَقِنَا عَذَابَ النَّارِ. These beautiful verses of Surah Al-Baqarah, what Sheikh Hassan recited a few minutes before the khutbah, what amazing, would shake you vigorously, would make you understand that you're dealing with Allah, who's literally able to do all things. There is not a thing which is impossible or hard for him. إِنَّمَا أَمْرُهُ إِذَا أَرَادَ شَيْئًا أَنْ يَقُولَ لَهُ كُنْ فَيَكُونَ. Tonight is the gate. If you have cancer, last stage, today, ask Allah which was certainty. Oh Allah, cure me. You will be cured. If you ask Allah which was certainty today, you'll be cured. If you beg, if you're looking to have a child, ask Allah not for a child, but for a goodly offspring. And He promised, not because I promised, but rather I'm communicating with you Allah's promise. Wallahi, Allah will fulfill. Only when you have that much trust and confidence in Allah the Almighty. Allah is teaching us through these beautiful and magnificent stories that we should put our trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that is based on taqwa. How much you committed, how much you got feeling. In Surah Al-Talaq, Allah Almighty says, وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا وَأَرْزُقْهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبُ. Whosoever fears Allah, Allah will give him a way out. Don't ask how. This is none of your business again. He is the manager and the disposer of all affairs. وَأَرْزُقْهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبُ. And He will provide for him through means which he could never imagine nor expect. Brothers and sisters, this is the time to make dua with sincerity. While having full trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If your yaqeen, if your tawakkul upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is deficient, your dua would not be looked at. And the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith, Zamzam lima shariba lah. The water of Zamzam is for whatever intention you drink it with. need you're asking Allah to be fulfilled. I understand that. I'm a big sinner. And many of us are indulged in major sins. And it is hard to quit. To quit your convenience store. To quit doing haram. To quit dealing with riba. To quit communicating with people on haram basis. This is the time to ask Allah sincerely right now. Oh Allah, help me to overcome sins and to avoid them. Help me to overcome my desire and to avoid sins. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith, which is collected by Imam al-Bukhari, مَا رُوِيَ الشَّيْطَانُ أَطْحَرُ وَلَا أَذَلُ وَلَا أَبْيَضُ مِنْهُ فِي يَوْمِ عَرَفَةٍ. A shaitan, Satan, was never seen more disgraced, more humiliated, and more angry than on that day on the day of Arafah. Do you know why? Because of seeing how much mercy Allah showers His servants with. He's been working hard throughout the entire year to mislead us. And in one day, Allah blows away all His effort. Allah erases all our sins. And even if you're not performing Hajj, fasting on that day, will expiate the sins of the past year and a year to come. We should not waste this opportunity. There is no more time to sleep today. There is no more time to rest today. A few hours until sunset. It is worth making ibadah. It is worth making dhikr. It is worth asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness. Subhanallah, after every act of worship, it is prescribed to beg Allah for forgiveness. You know what? After we leave from Arafah and we're already forgiven, inshaAllah, then we'll go to Muzdalifah, Fadhkurullah inda al-Mash'ar al-Haram. And we remember Allah much at the sacred Mash'ar in Muzdalifah. And Muzdalifah to Kulluha Mash'ar. Then Allah Almighty says, after you finish all, Astaghfirullah. Astaghfirullah. And istighfar is prescribed after every act of worship. Maybe through some deficiency, maybe some drawbacks, maybe I said something that upsets Allah or upsets somebody else. So anything that may ruin my day or my ibadah will be fixed by istighfar. After every prayer, once we say tasleem, what do we do? What is the first thing we say? Astaghfirullah, antaba yurid brother. Astaghfirullah, we say that three times, subhanallah. After every ibadah, it is prescribed to seek forgiveness. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says in the hadith, لَن نُدْخِلَ أَحَدَكُمُ الْجَنَّةَ عَمَلُوا. None of you shall enter paradise simply because of your good deeds. They said, Ya Rasulullah, not even you. He said, not even me. Unless if Allah covers me with His mercy. It is Allah's mercy which will admit us to His paradise. Not only our good deeds, because no matter how much you know of good deeds, it isn't sufficient. If we now run to Allah until the last moment of our lives, that would not be equivalent to a single ni'mah that He bestowed upon us. It would not be equivalent to His thanks to the blessings of the sight, of the hearing, or the breathing, or the heartbeat. Allah Almighty is most merciful. Brothers and sisters, take advantage of today to make it a turning point in your life. Take advantage of today to make dua as much as you can. Don't you think you're asking from a human being? Don't you think you're asking from a rich person? You're asking from Allah. So ask with no limits. Ask with no limits. Ask as much as you want. And everyone who asks you for a favor or for a wish, make dua for them. As you make dua for them, Allah Almighty will answer your dua and give you similar to that. In the hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, whenever a believer makes dua to another in his or her absence, Allah Almighty appoints angels next to him to say, Ameen! Oh Allah, accept his dua, wa lahu bimith, and give him my advice. So you automatically pray for others, and meanwhile you pray for yourself. Make istighfar, make dua, make dhikr. The entire journey of Hajj is all about making dhikr. إِنَّمَا جُعِلَ الطَّوَافُ وَالسَّعْيُ بَيْنَ الصَّفَا وَالْمَرْوَةِ وَرَمْيُ الْجِمَاعِ مِنْ أَجْلِ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ ذِكْرًا كَثِيرًا وَسَبِّحُوهُ بُكْرَةً وَأَصِيلًا. لَبَّيْكَ اللَّهُمَّ لَبَّيْكَ لَبَّيْكَ لَا شَرِيكَ لَكَ لَبَّيْكَ إِنَّ الْحَمْدَ وَالنِّعْمَةَ لَكَ وَالْمُلْكَ لا شريك لك لبيك. اللهم انصر الاسلام واعز المسلمين. بالشرك والمشركين. اللهم رد المسلمين إلى دينك ردا جميلا. اللهم هيئ لنا من أمرنا رشدا واجعلنا من عبيدك السعدا. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وكفر عنا سيئاتنا وتوفنا مع الأبرار. اللهم اغفر لنا ما قدمنا وما أخرنا وما أسررنا وما أعلنا وما أنت أعلم به منا. أنت المقدم وأنت المؤخر، لا إله إلا أنت. اللهم ارحم إخواننا بالشام، اللهم ارحم إخواننا بسوريا، اللهم ارحم إخواننا بسوريا. اللهم عليك بضاغية الشام، اللهم عجل بهلاكه وأعوانه، اللهم عجل بهلاكه وأعوانه. اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين في كل مكان، اللهم انصر إخواننا المستضعفين في كشمير وأهل السنة بالعراق وإخواننا بغزة. اللهم انصر المسلمين في كل مكان وتحت كل سماء يا رب العالمين. اللهم ألف بين قلوبنا، اللهم تقبل طاعتنا، ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم. اللهم اجعله حجا مبرورا وذنبا مغفورا وسعيا مشكورا وتجارة لن تبور. اللهم لا تردنا من هذا المكان خائفين، اللهم لا تردنا صفر لدينا يا رب العالمين. اللهم تقبل طاعتنا واصل حبتنا واصل ذلتنا. اللهم هيئ لنا من امرنا رشدا واجعل لنا من عبيدك السعدا. ربنا هب لنا من ازواجنا وذرياتنا قرة اعين واجعل للمتقين إماما. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين وسلام على المرسلين، وصلى الله على سيد الأولين والآخرين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه.